G'day, it's Clayton from Planet Canada. Today we're going to talk about how we can create a toe height attribute in cabinet vision, which is a very simple, easy method for changing the heights of our toes or kickers in all of our rooms at the same time. It's a very useful tool to have. So to do that, we're going to create a system parameter. If I click on the utilities tab at the top here, and then the parameters button underneath, you'll see this dialog box pop up. This is where we can create as many different attributes as we want in cabinet vision. Let's go through this process one by one and talk about what information we need to put in each field. The first field, prompt. In this space, we just want to put in an easy to reference name for our attribute so we know what it's doing, what it's accomplishing when we're working in cabinet vision. So here, we're just going to write change toe height. You can put in whatever name or description you want to. The next field though might be a little bit more daunting, especially if we're new to cabinet vision. We want to reference in this attribute the parameter which controls the height of our toes in cabinet vision. There is a very simple way to find this parameter if we don't know it off the top of our head. If I click on close on this window, and go back to the main tab and then help and help topics, I am going to try and search for the system parameter which is linked to the toe height. So I'm going to write in here toe height, and you'll see in the first option that's popped up, system parameters, I can double click on that. And this page is a big long list of all of the parameters in cabinet vision and what they do. If I want to try and find the toe height quicker, rather than sorting through it, I can click Control F, write in toe height, and voila, you can see that there is the toe height parameter that we're looking for, T-O-E-H, so I just need to remember that, or I can copy it and paste it as well. So we're gonna minimize the window, go back to utilities, parameters, and here in this field, we want to be controlling the toe height parameter. The next field now, the type, we're going to keep this as measurement because this is a value that we want to put in. But if I click on the drop down menu, you can see that we can create all sorts of different kinds of attributes as well with different types. This next field here underneath the value, I'm going to put in underscore CV238. The reason for that is because I am referencing with this formula the construction method linked to the toe height in cabinet vision. So to explain what I'm referring to there, the cabinet vision construction method number 238, I'm going to close down this box, click on my assembly methods, go exterior case, toe kick, and you'll see these are all the different parameters I have for my toes. If I find the one which is related to the height of my toes, you'll see up here I've got standard number 238. So you can see what value I'm referencing. If I close down these windows now and go back to the parameters, we can keep that like so. This next field underneath class, we can choose what level of cabinet vision we want this attribute to appear on. Do we want it to appear on a job level, or if I use the drop-down menu, on a room level, on our cabinet level, and then we can be even more specific on what kind of cabinets we would like to see this parameter or attribute available. Because we want to change the height of our toes, we probably don't want to make this a job level attribute because we could just control that with our construction method already. But when we're drawing up a job, it is very possible that we might need different toe kicks or different toe heights according to each room. So if I click on the room field here, and we're going to keep this as an attribute, our attribute is completed. It's ready to go. So let's see it in action. If I click on close, new job, and we will just open up a new job. We'll add a wall, go to my elevation, objects, and I'm just gonna add on a couple of cabinets, but you'll probably see automatically on the left-hand side that the room parameter is there that we've created, the change toe height. It's using at the moment the construction method value that we've referenced before, question 238. But now if I click on that space and change it myself, I can manually change all at the same time the height of my toes and kickers in cabinet vision. So this is going to be a very useful way for you to change those heights. It's a great tool to have, and I hope you've enjoyed watching.
Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you'd like to see more tutorials like this one, please be sure to like and subscribe. You can also check out our other videos that will help guide you on your path to becoming a cabinet vision power user.